Welcome back to the part 10 and action.
That light on gun you pull on me so amusingly.
What's going on over there? Do you need help, my pretty?
Nothing's wrong. I dropped a cigarette, but everything is under control. I'll have the fire out in a minute or two.
What's that? What's happening?
Trouble. Keep it up. The pyramid's surrounded.
I'll find out what the trouble is. Watch Stubber doesn't pull any tricks. If he does, shoot him in the head, not through the heart.
Why does it matter? He'll be dead either way.
His heart belongs to Tezcatlipoca.
That's not true. We just had dinner a couple of times.
My finger isn't loaded.
Nico, what are you doing here?
Firstly, I'm going to set Georges free, and then screw up Karzak's scheme.
No, I can't let you do that. Karzak has promised me power.
Raoul, wake up. The only thing Karzak has on offer is death. You may want to ask who he is, except you can't. Karzak murdered him.
You're lying. He is in Europe.
Sure, he's in Europe. In London, on a mortuary slab with two bullet holes in him.
But Karzak promised. When he frees Tezcatlipoca, we'll all be granted great power.
Listen to her, Raoul. Karzak's insane.
I don't know. I need to think.
You've let your mother do your thinking for you up to now. You need to think for yourself. Your mother and Karzak think alike. There's only one expendable member of the clan left, and that's you.
Mother would never betray me.
Oh, I'm tired of trying to reason with you, Raoul. Titi Poco. Watch this man, and if he makes a move, shoot him with your gun. George, I don't want to sacrifice you by accident.
You have no idea how glad I am to see you.
They were going to cut your heart out. I think I can guess. We can save the happy reunions for later. We've got to move. Come on!
Host. I know, Tezcatlipoca. I'm not too happy here either.
He knows this is Tezcatlipoca's pyramid, the house of the enemy.
Well, we can't stay here like rats in a trap.
And we can't go out the way we came in. It would be suicide. I'll have a look around. Maybe there's another way out. In the meantime, take this. It's the Coyote Stone. It might bring you luck.
managed to recover the stones from the village, then we might have a chance after all. Incidentally, what would Titty Poco have done if Graciento had moved?
Titty Poco? Nothing. He's given up violence. This was a time for action, not talk. The pattern meant nothing to me. The pattern seemed to have only religious significance. There was nothing I wanted to talk to George about just then. It was George, just rescued from certain death and not looking suitably grateful. Oof, the lever was very difficult to move and appeared to do nothing anyway. Still, no good. I'd already tried that. The lever was made of stone. There was a large image on the wall of a man in ceremonial garb. More useful, there were also a couple of levers. It was George, just rescued from certain death. On the wall was an intricate pattern in blue and gold. This was a time for action, not talk. I'd already tried that. It was Titty Poco. The pattern seemed to have only religious significance. Outside was certain death. By the door was a pattern picked out in blue. The pattern meant nothing to me.
Oh, what the shit.
George?
Yeah?
George, I can only pull one lever at a time, and I think we need to pull both together.
Okay, I'm up for that. Will cost us.
I think so, and I'm glad.
What?
The Mayans weren't fools. Tezcatlipoca should stay exactly where they put him.
Finally got some backbone from somewhere, huh? Shame it's so late in the day.
I'd rather die than see you a Kazakh in a day's hour.
Why, we're still a sacrifice show. See, the attempt begins. I will kill him. Tezcatlipoca done.
Nico was right all along, but it's still not too late.
Come on then, Pablo. Let's see who sacrifices who.
What place is this? I was in some sort of strange room, tiles and dyers. The priests who designed this place must have known how to use them. I was going to have to figure it out for myself if I ever wanted to get out of here. The dial didn't want to move. The dial moved slightly. The dial didn't want to move. 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 The room was dominated by an enormous device, decorated with the usual Mayan motifs. It held two great discs, each covered in glyphs. The dial didn't want to move. The dial didn't want to move. The dial didn't move at all.
Ah, piece of shit.
The dial didn't want to move. The dial didn't want to move. The dial didn't move at all. 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 The dial didn't want to move. 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 The dial didn't move at all. The dial didn't want to move. The dial didn't want to move. The dial didn't want to move.
Shit.
The dial didn't want to move.
What the shit.
Thank you. The Dyad didn't want to move. The Dyad didn't move at all. 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 The Dyad didn't want to move. The Dyad didn't move at all. The dial 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 didn't want to move. The tile didn't move at all. 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 The chute I'd arrived on was too steep and slippery to get back up. It was the great stone head that had spat me out. It reminded me of an ex-boyfriend, on both counts. The tile didn't move at all.
When see you at part 11. Bye bye for now.